I have soaked the rice. I put salt. Now give me that.
So what are you making over there? What is this that you're making?
Here.
Here.
Rice, curd rice.
Okay, and you said it's a special rice?
Jeera rice, jeera.
Okay.
Now give me that box with the ginger garlic. It's separate. I've kept it separate. See, when I want to start cooking, I bring the whole thing.
Oh.
So this is ginger.
This is about 1 tablespoon.
No, less than that. For 2 cups of rice.
Huh.
Because that ginger is good for the stomach.
How many cups of water?
Say for 2 cups, I put 5-6 cups because it has to be soft.
So 2 cups of rice.
2 cups of rice, 5 cups of water.
Okay.
Now put this back. I put salt. Okay.
Okay.
Now I'm going to cook it. Comes up, then I put the weight on.
Oh.
So meanwhile, I'll do this.
What is this? What are you making here?
Aloo Methi.
Okay. Methi. Aloo Palak.
Not Aloo Palak. Aloo is potato, this is Methi, not Palak. It's
Methi. Oh, it's not spinach, okay.
No, it is fenugreek.
Ah. Are those fresh fenugreek or?
Fresh.
Okay.
But I've boiled it and cut it up and steamed, dried up the liquid.
Is it the same procedure if I were to make aloo palak? The same procedure? Can I use palak instead of...
Yeah, you can. I like the taste of methi.
So I don't know if we get methi over there.
Fenugreek. I think all Indian shops have got quite a few onions.
Here you had 2 onions.
2 big onions. You can have more if you like.
Careful, you will cut your hand.
No, I'm used to it.
Why don't you use the whole onion?
What?
You're cutting out these cores.
I don't people use the cores.
Okay.
Papa has to have a vegetable every day, every meal. I'm looking after him quite well. Don't think that I'm not. Now there's ginger, garlic, green chilies. These are too many chilies. So many will do?
Yes.
Hmm?
Yes.
Just move, I'll cut things up. Just 1 minute. But you have to put 1 more chili, I think.
Okay.
3 tablespoons of oil.
Let me put the lid on it.
Give me that. When the oil is hot, I put 1 teaspoon of mustard seed. Maybe half a teaspoon. Half a teaspoon of mustard seed.
Okay.
Half a teaspoon of jeera seed.
Cumin, yes.
Okay, cumin or whatever. I use a little of this shakti chicken masala.
Okay.
Afterwards, not now. Let me sit down. You can get it anywhere. Wash thoroughly.
Oh.
So the rice is steaming.
Oh, I put the
mustard seeds have popped.
Yeah. All the onion capsicum. The onions have to be quite long.
Oh.
And then ginger, garlic and chilies are added. The garlic has to be fried properly. Otherwise the raw smell should go. At this stage you can put the chilies also and the ginger garlic.
Oh.
It will be fried very well. That raw smell should go.
Oh.
It should be completely cold.
How do you know that it's
what?
Cooked?
Which one?
The ginger garlic.
You can get the smell. You know?
Okay.
The raw smell should go.
But you haven't stirred it.
I've stirred it.
How shall I stir it?
Okay. Be careful, don't do it. Onion should be brown. Not very brown, it should be pale brown. It's too raw. At this stage you can add.
I thought you had turned off the flame.
No, why should I turn off the flame?
Okay.
It has to cook. You can add two teaspoons of.
How do you know it's 2 teaspoons? You didn't measure it.
It's by eye. I go by eye. Pepper, no?
Chili or black pepper?
Black pepper. This is sprinkling. And you can give me third from the left, yeah. No, yeah. That sort of enhances the teaspoon.
I'm surprised you didn't label it.
I know my things in the kitchen.
So this is fenugreek powder.
Mm. 1 teaspoon maybe less. Can put the potatoes. You can add this. Put a little salt.
Oh.
This much. After we see.
Salt.
After.
How long do you cook this? Do you turn it on low or is it on high?
It's on low.
And how, for how long?
Till the potatoes at the bottom are brown. Then okay. Give it a turn. And then keep it covered till the potato, the tomatoes have to be crushed.
Yes.
Breaking it, okay?
You have to stir it thoroughly without breaking it.
I put on high flame because there's still a lot of liquid.
Okay.
That will help to soften the vegetable. You want to taste it and see the salt?
No. When will it be done? Like, how will we know when it's done?
You can see the potatoes will be very soft.
And the tomatoes will be crushed.
I mean the tomatoes, the potatoes will be brown.
Okay.
So it should be like this.
No. How is it?
It's okay, but I usually put a little pinch of this paste maker.
Okay, you put it. You do it whichever way you do.
No, empty.
Okay.
It is just a seasoning powder.
Oh.
It's very good.
This step is only if you want to add taste maker.
Yeah.
Otherwise it's done.
Otherwise it's done, but you see our vegetables and our food these days have lost the natural taste.
Okay. They've lost the natural taste.
Yeah. Because it's all it's not organic.
Does it have a lot of chili powder in it?
No.
See?
Makes a lot of difference.
Oh.
It's extra spice. Okay.
Now we are going over to the curd rice.
Big spoon, not just big serving spoons. Fluffy and soft. Now it has to be made into milk.
Oh, you added milk, not curds.
Curd afterwards.
Okay. How much milk?
It's less than, but you can add more.
Is this is 1/2 liter of milk and this is so 1/2 kg of curd.
You can
three tablespoons of oil.
This is quite a lot. You can put a little ghee.
It's fine.
I like a little ghee.
How do you just pour like that? You end up pouring a ton.
I'm used to it.
Oh.
I'm not a new cook. I've been cooking for 57 years.
Okay.
Without that, it doesn't taste good.
Don't put too many.
Okay. It's only for
curry leaves and red chilies.
Wait. This
what is that?
Urad dal.
Oh.
Some chana dal. Mustard seeds. One teaspoon. It should turn brown.
Yes.
Oh, I forgot what. This is the dried methi.
Kasuri methi.
Yeah, kasuri methi. It's always nice. Gives it a beautiful flavor. That's enough. At the end, you can add.
You turned off the fire.
Yeah. Oh, it looks so fancy. You can check for salt afterwards when you're eating.
Okay.
There's no need to add more.
That's it. It's done.
That's it. Oh.